In this video, I'll be talking to you about Multicast DNS. Multicast DNS is a protocol that allows you resolve, you know, hostnames to IPs and IPs to hostnames. So essentially perform DNS-like operations in a network that doesn't have a local DNS server. So it uses multicast and it also uses UDP protocol, just like the standard DNS protocol. But instead of using 53 as destination port, I should say, it uses 5353. So in this case, this host is sending a standard query to the multicast DNS link local address, and it sends a QM query. So QM query basically means that this host will be expecting a multicast response back from anyone who responds. You also have QU. QU basically means that the host will be expecting a unicast response. But in this case, you send a standard query for m1.local. You're essentially trying to resolve m1.local. And you can take a look at the query itself, and you can see that you're trying to resolve m1.local. Now, if you take a look at the response, in this case, m1.local is actually the host that sent the request. But if you take a look at the response, you will see that you then have an answer. So it says m1.local is represented by this IP address 111.111.111.111. So this is a very simple example of resolving a host name to an IP address using multicast DNS. Now, if you want to look at how PTR records work, so you want to do the reverse. You want to be able to say for this IP address, what actually, what host name is mapped to this IP address. So if you take a look at this packet, we could see that this host sends a standard query and it says, does anybody on this network have a PTR record that ties this IP address to a particular host name? And if you take a look at the query, you can actually see the same thing there. We're asking the network, we're saying, does anybody have a PTR record that ties this IP address to a host name? And it's a QM query. So essentially, we're going to be expecting a multicast response back. So take a look at packet 27. We're able to see that we get a response, and this time we actually have a full mapping. So we have a complete PTR record that maps this IP address to m1.local. Now if you take out packet 17, we don't have that mapping, it's just a query. We don't know what this maps to, but when we get a response back, we're able to see that this PTR record or this IP address is mapped to m1.local. So this is how multicast DNS works. A very simple example. If you want to download the PCAP and take a look at the PCAP in more detail, check out the description. And remember to subscribe to my channel and give this video a like. Thank you very much for watching, and join me in the next video.